Hey, what's up, guys? It's Tech Confusion, and I've had people ask me, how do you get faster at editing? Well, other than experience with the software and familiarity with it, I would say the answer is keyboard shortcuts. They can exponentially speed up your workflow, and they really don't take that long to commit to memory. So today, I'm going to be showing you the top 7 Premiere Pro shortcuts you should know. Let's jump right in. So the first keyboard shortcut has to do with resizing your timeline and the tracks on your timeline. Now you may already know how to zoom in and out of your timeline, but if you don't know, it's the plus and minus keys. So if I hit plus here, each time I press it, the timeline will zoom in further, and it works the same way with the minus key. It will zoom out as I press it. But I want to take this a step further, and by adding a couple of modifier keys before plus and minus, you have some really cool and helpful sizing controls. Now modifier keys are keys like shift, control on Windows and command on Mac, alt on Windows and option on Mac. So let's say you want to adjust the sizing of your tracks here. By default, they're fairly thin. Well, if I press and hold shift on my keyboard, as I use the plus and minus keys, you'll see that I either increase or decrease the track height. This is helpful if you need to get to the keyframes for an audio track, or you just want to see the thumbnails on your video track. But then you may want to go back and forth between these two sizes, so using this shortcut can save you a lot of time, so you don't have to go to your timeline panel and manually adjust each track. Now if you add control on Windows and command on Mac with plus and minus, you can adjust just the size of the video tracks, just like I'm doing here. And if you add alt or option with plus and minus, you can resize only audio tracks. That way if you only want to make the video tracks bigger, it won't affect the audio tracks. Alright, for number 2, it's another shortcut that controls your timeline sizing, but this is something I use probably every 15 seconds while editing, and that would be the backslash key. What this will do is no matter where you are in your timeline window, no matter how far you are zoomed in, if you hit that backslash key right under the backspace key, your timeline will zoom out and fit to a perfect size to show you everything in your timeline. This is an essential and invaluable shortcut because let's say you just use the plus key to zoom way in and make a precise cut. Instead of messing with the scroll bar down here to change how much of your timeline you see, just hit this backslash key and it zooms out. Definitely worth your time building into muscle memory. Okay, number 3, if you don't already use these keys to play, pause, and rewind your playback, you need to. They are the J, K, and L keys. Now when in your timeline, if you press L, it'll begin playing through. And if you want to pause the playback, just press K. If you want to rewind, just press J. Now just these shortcuts alone save so much time, but let's say you want to play through something really quick and fast forward instead of just playing at normal speed. Well, the more times you hit the L key, the faster it will play through. And it works the same with rewinding with J. So if I press the L key 5 times here, you'll see that it speeds up each and every time I press it. If you didn't know about these shortcuts before, your mind is probably blown, but there's actually even more. Do you want to preview what a clip would look like in slow motion? Well, if you hold down the K and L keys, it will play at a much slower speed. And again, just like before, it works the same way with rewinding. Just hold down J and K, and it'll go backwards at a slower speed. You should totally start using these shortcuts. It saves you a ton of time because you don't have to use your mouse to navigate to a certain part in the timeline. Your hands can just stay on the keyboard. Now these keys also work in the source monitor as well, so if you're going through your clips before adding them to your timeline, you can just use these shortcuts to quickly find the parts of your clips you want. Speaking of the source monitor, we're going to talk about the 4th set of shortcuts. So let's talk about in and out points. If you don't know what in and out points are, basically you can use these to tell Premiere how much of a certain clip to bring down into your timeline from the source window. So I have this B-roll clip right here, and let's say I want to drop it in on top of my A-roll here in my timeline. Well, I don't necessarily want the entire clip in my timeline, so we're going to choose the range of what to bring down. So as I play back this clip here, I'll be looking for a good point to start the clip off with, and I'll choose right about here. So now with your playhead where you want the clip to start, press I. You'll see here that it moves this little open bracket in the right where our playhead is. Of course, I could always move this with my mouse manually, but to save time, it helps to use the keyboard shortcut I. Now, the out point is very similar. Let's just keep playing through the clip, and then I'll find where I want it to end. And then when I'm happy, I'll just press O on my keyboard for out. And let's say now I change my mind and I want the out point to be set a little bit earlier in the clip. Well, I can rewind using the helpful J key shortcut, and then just press O to update the out point. Now that my in and out points are set, when I drag this down to my timeline, you'll see when I play it back, it's only from my in and out point, rather than the entire clip being dragged down. Alright, number 5, we're going to be talking about a shortcut that speeds up rough cut editing exponentially, and that is the ripple delete function. Basically, this shortcut trims the beginning or ending part of a clip using the Q and W keys. So I have this clip here, and let's say I'm just going through it for a rough cut and cutting out the empty parts where he's not talking. So I watch it through and make my first cut here. Just like normal, I'll grab the blade tool and make the cut. Now I'll go forward on my timeline until he begins talking again. So right about here. Now usually people would pull out the blade tool here again, which is fine and it works that way, but the faster way to do this is ripple delete. Since I know I want to remove all of this dead space right here to the left, with my playhead where I want to make the cut, I'll press Q on my keyboard and it will delete everything after the first cut up to this point on my timeline where my playhead is at. And then let's say I'm watching this edit back now and I left too much space at the end of this first clip. Well, if I position my playhead exactly where I want the first clip to be trimmed and press W, it will ripple delete everything to the right of my playhead before the next cut. So just to recap, Q will delete everything to the left of my playhead and W will delete everything to the right of my playhead. Okay, for number 6, I'm going to show you a super quick and easy keyboard shortcut to toggle any panel to full screen. So let's say you're working on a smaller display and cannot see your entire timeline, and you need a way to make it bigger. Well, if you press the tilde key, which is the key right underneath your escape key, this will maximize or expand the current selected panel to full screen. Now when I press this, you can see the entire timeline, and then if you want to exit it, just press the tilde key again to minimize it. Now let's say you want to expand your program monitor for previewing playback. Just select the program window and press the tilde key. It will expand the exact same way. Again, super simple, yet very effective shortcut. You should definitely add to your workflow. And lastly, number 7, we have Control or Command D. This shortcut will allow you to place your default transition between two clips. So I have these two clips here, and let's say I want to put a crossfade between these. Well, I could just go through my effects window for the transition I want, or since cross dissolve is my default transition and that is the one I want, I can just select both of these clips and then press Control or Command D, and it will put a fade transition in for me. If you find yourself using a particular transition over and over again, make sure you set that as your default transition. You can do so under the effects window just by right-clicking it and then selecting that as your default transition. Then you can just select the two clips that you want the transition on and just press Command or Control D on your keyboard. And this is just the fastest and most simple way to make a quick transition. And that's all the shortcuts. You should definitely take the time to learn these because you'll find yourself editing faster in no time. In addition to these shortcuts, I definitely say you should learn the tool shortcuts. That way you don't have to manually select the tool from the toolbar, instead you can just press the key to switch back and forth. If you're interested in learning even more keyboard shortcuts, you can just head up to the Premiere Pro in your menu bar and select keyboard shortcuts, and that will pull up a window that shows you all the keyboard shortcuts for each key. Here you can also change them to fit whatever works for you. Anyways guys, that's all for this video. If you enjoyed it or found it helpful in any way, please remember to leave a like and don't forget to comment, subscribe, and hit that bell icon so you don't miss more videos like this. I hope you have a great rest of your day, and until next time guys, peace out.